Good day to you. I want to discuss with you two topics or two sections about the plot of land you have for your life, for cultivation and for a good harvest. So our life is about the seeds that we sow and the harvest we get and the seasons we go through. So people may say that spring, summer, autumn and winter, when our life begins to wind down, but getting ready for the nether season in the netherland is how I would positive with God, of course. But today I want to get into more brass tracks or basic things about what you have gone through already and the next room in preparation for our life journey, defining two aspects of life as a plot of land and seed to sow, harvest to receive, and a journey from room to room, designed and directed for destiny. I will first take the plot of land. How has your life been? All people go through four kinds of seasons or experiences regarding the plot of land, regarding the seed they get, the associations they get to have, and the harvest of that time period. So the first one I like to discuss is the roadside raven experience of life. That is a season when you had this season. And if it, with the digitizing generation, it comes between 14 and 21. So many outside influences come so quickly into their life. Also, when you're about to enter halftime, passing 40, the naughty 40s as people say, things that you did not expect can happen to your morals, can happen to your health. So two seasons to watch in the young people, the 14 to 18, because that sets them on a course, sometimes irrecoverable. And for adults, the time from 39 to 45, shall I say, when it should be a very good success concluding season and significance beginning season. Because from, to give you a rough, quick survey, till 13 you do as your parents say, from 14 you begin to have more influence from outside, from peers. 14 to 18 should be a good stretch, curriculum, getting ready for career. Then 19 to 24 you settle on your career, and of course you can settle on your life companion also, since that's once for all time, once for all choice, you have to choose carefully. Then till 33, you run up your first stretch of real life. I shouldn't say real life, first stretch of life, work life. Then by 33, if you achieve one third of what your potential is capable of, then you will be satisfied at 33. Then 33 to 43, you work for success, as people understand success. Then from 43, at 43, you got two thirds set for. Then I want to point out, by 43, your child is at least 14. Then you have to think more and more of your child who is 14, and best career is home always. So then 43, up to 43, you have done two thirds of your life, career wise. And then there's one third left for significance, when you become good steward for others to do well. So good stewarding begins with your own family and others to do well. And in this talk, I'm including both spouses together, then other juniors doing well under your shade. So this is how God designs life, if you may. So in that context, I'm looking at this roadside raven experience that can come to you between 14 to 18 of age, or between 40 to 44 of age. It's a time when associations that you didn't expect, shall I say, invade your life like ravens in the air. But that is because you kept it open. You did not keep your safeguards, security coverings. And then it's like a roadside experience. You got onto things that you did not know quite well. And then you trampled on the seed that you had for greatness and for your next harvest. I'm not saying you have to go through this. I'm only saying watch these circumstances when they come up, most likely between 14 to 18 and 40 to 44. But it can come at any time. You would have heard of people who were doing so well and noonday destruction came to them, or arrow from far came to them, or inexplicable dark thing came at them, which is called a terror in the night, or a disease came at them, or a snare came at them. Snare is, of course, where you put your foot, sometimes knowingly, thinking you can play with the snare, the trap. Just the way that particular gray colored that fellow who likes to get into honey, you know, in Sinhala you call him Ambalaya, and that chap gets into the honey pot thinking I'll quickly have a little and come out. Second time also he says I think I can have a little more and come out. Third time he tries to go, he can't. He drowns in the thing he thought was honey. So you understand what I'm saying. So this is roadside, raven side, during which time the snares of a bird catcher that you were flying so well, but your wings got clipped in some nasty experience. Two, it was arrow that was aimed at you, and you may know the one who sent it. It might have been sorcery. It really hit you. Thirdly, it may be a dangerous disease like dengue that you did not know, or COVID for that matter. Or a dark thing that came from somewhere. It's a family line thing. Don't know how it came. It's an immunity thing. There are such things that are not very explicable. They came. Or it may be a terror by night, quite an inexplicable trend of events that caused your downside. Or it may be a sudden disaster when you are flying so well. It's called noonday disaster, which may be noonday, meaning it was your brightest time, and something came at you. And then, of course, any other massive destruction that others are also prone to, you know, natural disasters and things like that. So I included those seven factors in this roadside raven experience. Who were ravens? People who should not have had access to your life, who came and they plucked out the good seed God had for you, seniors had for you, parents had for you, destiny had for you. Now, des is the Latin for God. So, destineo means a God design. You may not believe in God. I, of course, do, but we commonly use the term destiny. So this, I tackle this not so good period of life first, because many may have experience. You hear of conglomerates that were doing so well and got ensnared in some bad investment and they crumbled overnight and they became a smelly bad name. But God can save. Even in a situation like that, God can save. Other thing about this roadside, raven side is there are so many unnecessary people that you did not know, new associations who saw your prosperity and got attracted to you, and they came in and they trampled the values on which you built something. And because they quickly gave you success and you thought so, you allowed them to invade your life and they trampled the seeds for the next harvest to work with God. So God is not into by hook or by crook, you know that. So wrong people, wrong influences coming in, and then they are snatching the good seed away and they're trampling your life. In the sense, you're agreeing to this, you're becoming harder. So many other influences coming in which were not there in your formative years, and a bit of a wild season. You thought it's a controlled wild season, but you couldn't. So it was a time like that. Then the next plot I'm examining that you could go through is a rock side. That is some situations, you were a nice chap, some situations came, you were a helping kind, and the response was not good. There was a Judas who betrayed or whatever. you were trying to be the helpful chap, and then you said, it's better not to help anybody. I will not touch him with the long end of a barge pole. You said things like that. Now, we know God is into always touching people, getting close to tough customers. He's in that God business of things. Anyway, the rock side is a situation or a period of time. You hardened your heart. You looked soft on the top. At the bottom, there was a hard layer. And the seeds that were there for that time took a little root. Then external circumstances also got hard. Maybe a relationship got hard. Maybe economics got hard. Boss got hard. Associated country went through a bad patch. You understand rock side? Yes. That was not your fault. Maybe not. You didn't even choose it. Not that you. It is just that you increasingly became fearful, offended, grief stricken, and things hardened up. And you have to watch that, because it reacting is easy than restoring. You know that. So that's the time you need a good shepherd. This wonderful theme. He is the good shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures and besides nice clear waters, which means your heart is not allowed, your life is not allowed to become rock hard, because you miss it. Others did it and you harden, and the seeds God had for that harvest was suppressed because it didn't grow. Ultimately, you lose it. So you need to take care of the reactions that make you hard. It may last one day, it may last one week. During that one day, there was a very good association that was coming, a connection, business opportunity. You spoke tough. You didn't mean to, but it just came out. And that partner who was seeking investment, particularly at this time, we want Sri Lanka to have lots of investment coming. That's our hope. And that call came, and you were in a toughened situation. You were reacting to the last bad thing, and your voice came out very uncooperative, and you missed it. So you understand rock side. Rock side was an unfortunate thing. You didn't plan to be like that. So take care of that. Then comes the thorn side. What is a thorn side? It was a season of harvest. You had sown wise seeds, good seeds, but very unwisely. This is unwisdom. Unwisely, you took in the cares of others. Then you might have taken a temptation or two, which is called pleasures of sin, cares of things, pleasures of other things that are not good pleasures, or the deceitfulness of riches. That is, you got a season of rich quickly, and you behave like a fool. Fool is one who did not assess what he should do with what he has. In the Greek, there are two meanings, even in the Hebrew. One is folly regarding not getting wise, folly here. Other one is even worse, folly here. In Sinhala also, we have this thing, modaya and jadaya. Now, don't think that is a bad word. You understand, first one is lack of this knowledge or wisdom. Other one is something your heart got corrupted, that heart wisdom, heart caution you lost. Thorn side is three things. You took in chaos. Of course, you had to be. It may be a son's care who's abroad studying, and COVID came, and then business went down and you can't pay school fees or whatever. But you got care worn. That becomes a thorn on your side. You can't rest in the night. You wake up without proper sleep. You understand thorn. So that was not your fault at all, circumstances. But you took the grief reaction too hard. Then comes the pleasures of sin. You just got trapped in it. You thought you'll escape with it, but it brought a moral folly. That is what pleasures of sin is. Don't try it. Every bit of alcohol changes your judgment. Every molecule of C2H5OH, now you may know that I was the head of Department of Pharmacology in a state medical faculty. My name is Dr. Lalit Mendes. So pharmacology is my theme, molecules and chemical molecules and their effect on the brain or body organs. So if you want any more clips on these lines, please send us a WhatsApp to plus 94 77 49 59 214. Yes, so the second one that causes this thorn-side thing, thorns coming up in your life, was his moral indiscretion. Yes. Third one is deceitfulness of riches, meaning you thought you will always have it good and money went into your head. So you made unwise investments, you jumped too high, and there's a voice that says when you come to a certain summit, the summit, let's say your present hill is about 10 meters high. Then the next attempting about 3 meters more is okay. You're 10 meters high. Just imagine you're 10 meters high in business, in life. Attempting a stretch, a faith stretch or speculation stretch, investment stretch, just 30% more is reasonable. 50% more is too much of a stretch. But if you attempt from 10 meters to 20 meters, that's folly. That's what deceitfulness of riches means. Because you made it good in a certain level of income, you take a high five and then it causes you crash. So we know people who crash like that. So that is the thorn side. So may you be spared of all this. Let wisdom be there. There's a thing called the peaceable wisdom. Wisdom that comes from heaven. Wisdom that comes from heaven. It is peaceable, it is godly, it is caring, it is protective, it is willing to share, and it gives you tolerance, and it gives you compassion, and it gives you patience. The other wisdom, that wise in you to get it, it is no peace. You listen to watch your peace inside. I think it's a God sense. When you lose your peace, you have trouble, you have butterflies in the stomach. Don't go that way. Then you become increasingly ungodly in the way you respond to juniors, even to your spouse. Then you lose sense of protection. You become risky, risk-taking. Then you don't want to share at all. You begin to grab. You grab more than just, and grab from others. You think you can prosper that way. What is this wisdom? This wisdom is no good wisdom. No good wisdom. Because earlier I described the good wisdom. Then you lose your tolerance. You are very, for the slightest thing, you get irritated, intolerant. And then no compassion at all. You become a real pharaoh, might is right, struggle for existence, fittest survive, and you say things like that. So two kinds of wisdom. Yeah. Take care that you remain with the wisdom God has for your life track. I have done roadside ravens. I have done rockside hardening. I have done thorn side, the three kinds of things that bring thorns into your life. Then of course you have the good side. In the good side also, that good season, you may produce tenfold, 30-fold, 60-fold or 100-fold. What determines whether you get it's a good side. Out of that project, you got tenfold. Probably your first one, God will allow you to handle what you can handle. And the best or the max potential is 100. That is according to all that has gone into you. God's scope in you produces. So another person's 100-fold may be a company that employs 10,000. But your 100-fold may be a venture that employs 10 people. It's a God's scope. See, contentment is the thing with godliness. So there are four kinds of people: ungodly and discontent, godly and content, that's a good one. Then there are some people who are ungodly, but they feel they have it all. They're wicked to others, but they feel they are master of the situation. Nothing will put them down. Then there's the most contradictory kind. They say they are godly, but they're always complaining, grumbling. Yeah, so four kinds of people on these two natures. You'll have to listen to this again, and I hope this is soft enough, easy to understand enough even to sit with your son or daughter who is 14 to 18. That's the hope of this talk. I've tried to keep it very simple, because sometimes when I do a professional talk, I get complaints that my language is complicated or the content is complicated. That is because in my talks, I include professors, my former students and lecturers and so on. But this is simple home stuff today for the happy hour. So that we have now finished the plots, four plots. Now I want to get on to the thought about room to room. So I want to define life as a journey from room to room. And the preparation time is passageway. Say with me, passageway. Now remember, life has passageways. It is preparation time. It is quiet time. It is God preparing you for your best potential in the next stage. Be patient. So room time is this first one. When you come into this room, your next phase of life, first thing to do is catch up and correction for what went on in the room earlier. Now remember, room time is limited, but enough, because God who ordains a room for your next journey, for your life journey. So room time is most easily understood by the age periods, not to 5 to 10. 10, I like to finish 10 to 12, 12 to 14 is a very special window of opportunity that you have to develop well. Then 14 to 18 is a very critical time. Similarly, 18 to 24, I have already said, is a very critical time. Then begins the life stretch. So anyway, room time could be a season of life, or could be just a year at a time or a month at a time. So it's a matter of what room you are looking at, but always there's a passageway, which is preparation. So when you come into this room time, will you say in a room time, you have an idea that it's a destiny, it's a God time, he prepared this place. And then first part of it is catch up and correction. That's a time you will need help. So be a little humble about who are the others in the room. Of course, there's your dad and mom, siblings. There may be seniors. There may be colleagues at the same level, peers, and there are juniors. There'll be people just like you, and there'll be people just not like you. So I use this for, in this room you'll have, let's say this is a brick, so to say, like a brick on a wall. There'll be people on whom you are resting on, they have been there before you, and people who want to rest on you, your juniors asking for support. Then in the room time, there'll be people on your right side just like you, there'll be people on your left side just unlike you. They're also necessary, you can't chuck them out. Then there are people who have gone further than you have, even in that period of time, learn from them. Don't be jealous of them. Then there are others who are not as smart as you, got less than you. Help them along. Did you understand that you're a brick in a room? Okay. Then, so this first part of the room time is catch up time, correction time. There's a little time. Make maximum use of it. It's going to get hectic. Second one, the curriculum begins. Now, curriculum may be actually studying, all the job description, all the project you are handling, all the relationships you are handling. So the curriculum in a given room has different things. Got it? Yeah. That's the curriculum of life. It'll involve your job, parents, siblings. At the stage the life partner comes in, it'll involve your life partner also. So curriculum time, you have to implement the curriculum, initiate, navigate, successful in conclusion, well done, good reward motive. Is our stimulus catalyst for next on your mark, get set, go, breast the tape, you understand? Always work on the last reward motive to get you in. I have done this many times before. If kids don't end up with a reward motive, but does digitizing and all kinds of things all the time, multitasking, then their brain gets really bottom-up regulation and they'll not do any curriculum. They'll be just doing circles and, you know, and saying, to put me to another course, put me to this course and so on. So for adults and young, there's a curriculum to be done in the room time. The third C I want to do is compassion. Care and share is high up in the heart of God. So whenever you are in a room, I explain to you, there'll be people ahead of you Don't get jealous of them, learn from them. There'll be people behind you. Be kind to them. Because when you get behind, God will be kind to you. That's how life works, compassion. Fourth C is connections and companions that may involve in that right season, that life partnership designed becomes visible. If you are working with God, it is so much better. He has better wisdom than you do for things you don't know. So that's the humility we need, the neediness of heart. If I can today, I'll get on to that seven qualities that help us through rooms and plots, because today our discussion is rooms and plots. But if I can, I'll get on to the seven characters that help us through plots and rooms. So the third one was compassion. Fourth C is connections and companions, very important. Some of them will stay with you for a season. Some of them will stay with you for life, maybe, if you are doing a company. Long-term covenanted people. Learn the word covenant, which is give and take, not grab. Yeah, give and take, yes. So fourth one is connection and companion. Fifth one is course completion. Then only you see the next door appearing on the wall to the next room. So course completion is important. Coursing through all the necessary curriculum material, learning, connecting relationships, and then only you should get to the next door. Now sometimes because of power, wealth or influence, political, young fellows get catapulted into a room in which they don't know what to do. They damage themselves, injure themselves, they torture others. So we have to tell politically powerful people or others who have other influence, power in the corporate or just wealth or manipulation, don't get yourself catapulted into a room you don't know to handle. That was due to come in God's design. Wait patiently. Haste makes waste. Yes. So we have done the five qualities of the room. Then my third part of my talk, I think I can handle it, the seven qualities that go to manage your plot season or your room allotment. Now, when you backtrack, you will understand, listen to this again, speak in this language to your young fellows, your juniors or your own kids. The seven qualities. One, blessed are the needy because they'll ask for help and then they will help others. So when we are needy, we get help, even from God. Secondly, blessed are the meek who make room for others. They get bigger plots of earth to occupy, get dividends from, invest, work with. Blessed are the meek, meaning those who make room for others. A third character is blessed are the mourning. That means those who show patience, compassion, and sorrow with others when they err. So this is the principle of the cross of the Good Shepherd. You absorb the errors of others and absolve as much as you can. So you are not into confrontation. You are not into justice for others, mercy for me. It doesn't work like that. You are not into, hang the fellow, that kind of thing. No. You are not into that. You are into, you mourn when someone is doing wrong. Government, your colleague, your spouse, your son, that's the time to sit with them. I have told you, there is a generation that is always experimenting with thrills, perils and errors. Mistake management, dad, you have to do it. You sit down and absorb the things that went wrong. That's a very good investment time. That's the principle of the cross. Putting right with what went on. That opportunity will come your way even in a corporate setting or a professional university setting. So that's about the mourning attitude that makes others feel you are a coach, a mentor, human resource person, that you are getting it right for another person is a very important character. Then the fourth one is blessed are they who have a hunger and thirst and a passion for righteousness, meaning getting it in straight lines. There are people like engineers, surveyors, lawyers who have to get it in a straight line, teachers, even doctors regarding prescription. So be a helper of straightlining things. Did you understand? Don't make it crooked for yourself and others. You know how it goes. When a regime gets crooked and having fans, it is very difficult to get work out of fans and sycophants. Yes, it is easy to get their legions, but to get real work out of them is very difficult. So keep your straight lines. Have a passion for keeping straight lines, okay? Then the fifth quality we like to have is blessed are the people who keep things pure, meaning don't mix your seeds. Don't mix the good with the ugly and the bad. Man's first problem was he wanted to know, out of this sugar cane, besides the good, what can I get? Yes, you got molasses. That's how it happened. Yes. Out of sex, besides the good, what can I get? You got it? You got pornography and all the deviations. One more. Out of nuclear power, it was possible for man to discover nuclear power. Besides getting electricity, what else can I get? Bomb the fellows. So you see how knowledge of the nucleus was possible. New knowledge of the atom was possible. And how to split the atom was possible. How to split the atom in a safe chain reaction was possible. But then the way we use it is that man's insatiable desire to get on from good to the other side. Have a check on this. Good to the other side. You be one who will say, no, we cannot mix in our project, in our company. We will stick to that which is good. Don't mix for short-term profit that which is not good. A little leaven leavens the whole lump. A little pus, you know, you can't say, I have a little pus, you know, that yellow thing, hairy thing. You can't say it's only a little, no. When a little comes, it'll begin to spread. If it's a limb, until gangrene has spread, you have to chop off the leg. That's the medical language. So don't start with a little. Then the sixth one, blessed are the peacemakers. That is to say, those who maintain the peace in a situation, speak for peace and reconciliation between races, between whatever situation. Yes. So you watch your words in any discussion, you speak for peace. On FB, Instagram, Twitter, wherever, you speak and write for peace. Watch it. Peacemakers are very, very, very rare. So that particular passage says, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be like God's children. That's a God quality of keeping peace between huge nations and rich and poor and outcast and low caste. So it's a huge process. So those are some of the characters that you can work with in your plot and in your room. Thank you. I'm going to stop.